In this video, we're going to take a look at reader mode or reader view in Safari on the iPhone. With reader mode, what we're able to do is strip out all of the ads or what I call noise when we're reading an article in Safari. We can even have it open up into reader mode automatically when we visit specific websites. Let's take a look at reader mode or reader view in Safari on the iPhone. Let's go to my iPhone. Now, before we get started, I am using iOS 16, but this does work on older versions of iOS. So if you're using an older version of an iPhone or iOS on an iPhone, you still will be able to use this reader mode or reader view. All right, let's first discuss what reader mode is. Let's demonstrate what reader mode is. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to Safari here. Now, when we are browsing an article or reading an article, let's go ahead and tap on this article here. What happens is we get a lot of ads. So when I swipe up here, you're going to see that there are a lot of ads in this article. Well, when we go into reader mode or reader view, what it'll do is it'll strip all of those ads out. So how do we do this? Well, basically, all we have to do is just go down to our address bar. Now, you're going to see that my address bar is not showing here. It's down towards the bottom, but it's not there. So the first thing that I need to do is I just need to swipe down, and then I can see the address bar. We go over to these double A's here, and when I tap on it, you're going to see Show Reader. I tap on it, and now when I look at this article here, you're going to see that there are no ads. To go back to the full article with all the ads, all we have to do is just show the address bar again, and then we tap on this, and then we go over and hide the reader. Now there's a shortcut to that. Now that takes a couple of steps. Well, if we long press on the double A's, watch what happens. I'm going to long press on this. It goes into reader mode. So how do you think we get out of this? We long press on this again, and it brings us back out. Now we can also set this up to go into reader mode automatically when we visit a specific website. So let's say that every time I go to Yahoo here, what I would like it to do when I'm reading an article is go into reader mode automatically. In order to do that, what we do is we go to an article. So I have this article here. And then what we do is we go back over to our double A's. We don't long press on it. What we need to do is just tap on it. And instead of going to Show Reader, what we do is we go over to Website Settings. When I tap on Website Settings, what I'm able to do is use Reader automatically when I visit yahoo.com. So now let's go ahead and turn on the slider over here. And now anytime that I visit an article on Yahoo, let's go ahead and go to this article here. Watch what happens when I tap on it. It goes into reader mode automatically. If I wanted to take it out, all I have to do is just go and long press on this. But now let's go over to CNN. You're going to see that when I go to CNN, what we're going to do is just go over to a little more pleasant news. We're going to go to entertainment here. And I'm going to tap on this article here. When I tap on this, you're going to see it does not go into reader mode automatically. That's because CNN is not set up for that. So what I have to do is I have to long press on this, and then it goes into reader mode. Now, if I wanted CNN to go into reader mode automatically as well, what I do is I go over to my double A's, I tap on it, I do not long press on it. We go over to our website settings, and then from here I'm able to set CNN to use reader mode automatically. So let's go ahead and do that. And now, anytime I go to an article in CNN or Yahoo, it's going to go into reader mode automatically. Now, we can also view all these websites and manage these websites that we're using reader mode automatically for. In order to do that, what we do is we go over to our Settings app. So I'm going to swipe up, and then we go over to our Settings app. And then from here, what we do is we swipe up until we find Safari. When we're looking at Safari, we have a lot of different settings here. The one that we're looking for is Reader. When I tap on Reader, you're going to see that I have my CNN and Yahoo here. If I wanted to turn one of them off or both of them off, all I have to do is just tap on the slider here to turn them off. I can also remove them. This will put it back to its default behavior. I'll talk about that shortly. But when I tap on Edit up here, what I'm able to do is select any one of these, and then I can delete it. Now, what about that default behavior? Let's say I wanted to go into reader mode automatically for all websites. Well, we can do that too. You're going to see that we have other websites. All I have to do is just turn this on, and now for any website that I visit in Safari, as long as there's an article there, what it's going to do is go into reader mode automatically. And then from here, what I'm able to do is exclude specific sites. So let's say I didn't want to have it go into reader mode automatically for Yahoo. I just tap on it, and now for any other site besides Yahoo, it's going to go into reader mode. So we can set up the default behavior as well. Instead of turning on reader mode automatically for specific sites, we can turn it on for all sites and then turn it off for specific sites. A troubleshooting tip, let's go back over to Safari here. Now, if you go to a website and it doesn't go into reader mode automatically, in some cases, what you may need to do is just go and refresh the page. So I just tap on this arrow going clockwise, and what it's going to do is refresh the page. And then in some cases, what that will do is that will force it to go into reader mode. Most of the time, it'll go into reader mode automatically, but I have seen where a couple times what I may need to do is just refresh the page. Also, this does not work on all websites. It works on most, but it doesn't work on all. You may find a website where reader mode is not available. That's because the developer wants you to see those ads, so they have put in some extra code where it won't go into reader mode. So not all websites are compatible with this, but most of them are. So that is reader mode or reader view in Safari on the iPhone. Basically, all we have to do when we're visiting a page that has an article is just long press on the double A's when we view the address bar. From there, what reader mode will do is strip out all the different ads. And if you want to set it up for specific websites, just tap on the double A's and then you can set it up to go automatically into reader mode on that specific website. So that is reader mode or reader view in Safari on the iPhone.